Today, let me address section 24 and 25 of the Hindu Marriage Act. This is in reference to maintenance. There is a widespread assumption that maintenance is limited only to wife. It's only wife who can claim maintenance from the husband. Whenever there is a marriage breakdown, is not subsisting, and there are enough legal grounds for breakdown of the marriage, and in the process the maintenance application is put up. However, let me make it very clear that the very assumption and presumption of maintenance is only for the woman, for the wife, is unfounded in the law. Section 24 and 25 is not gender specific. So it is uniform. It's applicable to both husband and wife alike. However, whenever there is an application put up for maintenance, the application must fulfill certain conditions. Must satisfy the Honorable Court. The conditions are that there should be an incapacity for the earning, or the earning, present earning, should be insufficient for the maintenance. For example, if the maintenance amount is arrived at 1 lakh and the present earning is 40,000, so the rest of 60,000 is insufficient. That can be taken into consideration by the court, provided if it is proved to the court, if the court is convinced with the claim. So first is incapacity of earning, the second is insufficient earning, and the lifestyle of the spouse, the applicant spouse, after marriage. What was the lifestyle she was living in, she or he was living in, and what are the comforts, the house, the living conditions, the conveniences, the necessities, the area of stay, the area of residence, the type of vehicles used, and court will also look into the type of income, the quantum of income of the payee as against the recipient, the income tax paid, the bank bonds, the fixed deposits, assets both fixed and movable. It can be a car, it can be a residence, it can be the plots, it can be bank shares, it can be debentures. So many, all these things can be taken into consideration vis-a-vis payee and the recipient. The total income, total capacity of the payee, and total incapacity of the recipient. Based on this, the court will arrive to an amount of maintenance. The maintenance can be monthly, it can be quarterly, it can be half yearly and yearly. There is no specified time. It is not necessary, it has to be monthly. And it can even be one-time settlement. So with this, we'll come to the end of this session.